I can't agree more with you.
That's what I'm saying.
It's that I don't believe that I have to have a Valentine's Day.
It's very annoying.
Wife's Day or a Mother's Day.
It's very
Day.
Annoying.
Like a Mother's
no.
Day cannot be a mother.
No, but it's not that.
It is
you just,
that.
You just need a reason. Today is the day I want to express it to you.
Why does Rose have to signify your love for you?
No, but it's not.
It's been a few months since we finished.
Quite a few months now.
And I have had very mixed feelings about Arya.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. You know, I thought I was very different from him. And I discovered otherwise. Instead of bringing Madhavan onto Arya, by the end of the show, it looks like Arya brought himself onto me. And I've actually changed.
You think Arya's rubbed off on you?
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's Manu who's rubbed off on me. Arya.
That makes more sense. I can buy that.
But tell me, did you bring in a little bit of
So I haven't actually shared this with you or with anyone, but when I read Shruti for the first time, I don't know, is it just this part or I find a lot of commonalities between every part that I've actually played. Mm. And with Shruti, also because the dynamic is, I mean, not between Shruti and Arya, but you know, there's a husband and she's working and there's a child is the same space that I'm in, right? And I mean, yeah, I can beat my drums and say, oh my God, it was so hard to play Shruti. But actually, it wasn't. In hindsight, I had to bring home to work.
I'm going to ask you a few questions that
oh,
I've written down.
I have my list ready.
All right, great.
Yeah.
Just to understand how much of Shruti and Surveen are similar or different, okay?
Well.
So I'm going to ask you a first question. We have a daughter who's 9 years old.
Yeah.
At what age are you planning to have the talk?
Oh my God, that blessed question.
And how will you approach
it? Oh, and that blessed thought. It's a scary thought. My kids these days are exposed so early in life. In their lives, like for my daughter's life, it would be odd 2.5 years, right? But I'm always constantly thinking about the talk, you know, and the transition from being, let's say now a toddler to a slightly grown up child into their teens and everything that teenage brings with it. It's tough. It's a tough one. And I remember right from day one, even when as a chotu, few days old baby that she was, I would address her like a grown-up person.
Mm.
I consciously made that choice and I decided to speak to her like an adult.
Yeah.
And I think she needs to be well-informed. There will be less of the curiosity is what I plan to kind of keep down and inform her as much as I can about, you know, the process.
That would be a good beginning. But the thing is, I think with my son, I can't agree more with you. Where do you say you treat him as like an adult?
Mm.
I remember going to the Lido Broadway show in Paris, okay? Mm. It said no age group.
Mm.
So when we took Vedant, who was 10 years old at that time, to the show,
mm.
nobody, you know, looked at us differently because there were other kids who were 10 years old.
Mm.
And then the show started. It was fine for some time. And then they brought in the artistic topless dancers as well. And there were 20 of them. My wife just froze, looking at the screen like that. And I'm like, okay, this is going to be interesting. And I remember Vedant looking at it for a while. And then they were dancing topless. And then he looked at me. And I looked at him and I said, son, you know, you're an artist, son. What you're seeing right now is art. There's nothing to feel shy about. If you're feeling uncomfortable about it, then we can go out. But it's okay for you to understand mm. where it's coming from.
Mm.
That guy looked at the stage. He clapped in the end. He maintained his dignity. He never sniggered. He never smiled. He never felt embarrassed. And then I realized that now I'm not going to have an embarrassment or a challenge conversing with him for the talk.
That's what I'm saying.
Hmm.
Now, between Vedant and Eva, yeah. it's actually going to be a different world.
Possibly.
Okay, possibly. So that the conversation,
yeah, so
the chat that you're saying had happened at his age at 10.
Yeah.
I mean, during
would have happened at 14 for us and now maybe at 8 for her. But do you think Shruti would have done that with Rohini?
Yeah.
She would have had the talk?
She would have had the talk.
Arya would have wanted that opportunity so much.
Yeah, yeah, but Shruti would have, I think, taken the reins. Protected her from Arya.
From the barrage of words that Arya is capable of. This Pulp Fiction writer will make that into Pulp Fiction. So, I'm going to the next question. You're shooting first.
Okay.
I'm shooting first.
Okay.
Okay. Now, Surveen, you've done some exceptional work on OTT and all the films that you've done.
Thank you.
And, you know, being from Punjab and being from the sort of background that you are and from the family that you are, my question to you is, I'm sure your parents watch your work.
Of course.
And I'm sure they're very proud of it. But do you ever think you have to justify to them about the work you're doing?
You know, actually my grandfather took everybody by surprise because I was the youngest in my family, extremely orthodox. And he said, Jaane do.
Oi, oi.
Oh my God, I cannot begin to tell you that sight and that the sound of that Jaane do to my ears, I still remember. Had it not been for him, I wouldn't have been here. But nevertheless, once I came to Bombay, I don't know, my parents just suddenly made a 180 degree. They had a 180 degree change.
Wow.
I don't know what kind. Yeah, I don't know what happened to them. I mean, I cannot thank them enough for being so understanding and supportive and to really see the work that I do with the right eyes.
But unfortunately for me, I have a problem here. Every time I do an intimate scene or a romantic scene or a smooching scene, my family photographs start rotating around my face. It's terrible.
In my case, everybody's used to it.
I got to get rid of that shit. Yeah, this conversation is so much fun. So this is a serious question, which will have a bearing to what we do in coquetry, which is, as a married person, what are the red flags, according to you, in a relationship that you think people should keep a lookout for?
I feel like you can just sense when somebody's not 100% there, when somebody's not present in the moment with you. And this is a different not being 100% there. And that for me is a red flag. Does not necessarily mean there is an external reason for it. It could just be that there's not enough work being done, you know, towards on the relationship. And for me, that is very, very important.
And there's a saying in Tamil, like where there's wrath, there is love. Mm. There's anger and, you know, you're fighting. Mm. But there is still love because you care. And the death of the relationship starts when the indifference sets in.
Indifference sets in.
Yeah, when you don't care how an argument ends. So that for me is a big red flag.
Okay, so the question says, what are the quirks you have that your partner complains about the most? You could be the other way around as well. So, I think you have all the leeway in the world too.
So, now, like Arya, I have quirks that are sometimes very irritating. Okay? First thing is, I'm very indecisive about the insignificant things in my life. For example, hey baby, you want to go out for dinner? Yeah. Which restaurant? Let's go Italian. And Sarita will say, great. Or should we go Spanish? Arya, should we try Maratha? And she's like, you know, by the end of the whole conversation, she's like, we are going here and we're going at this time. So get your ass on the car at that time and that's it. She hates that indecisiveness about me. And important decisions in my life, like this is the line moving on.
You mean it's those smaller things that...
But you know, I'll drive them nuts. Okay. Then I think the quirk that I have the most is that I don't believe that I have to have a Valentine's Day. Or a...
It's very annoying.
Wife's Day or a Mother's Day.
It's very annoying. It's just a way to celebrate. Yeah, it's just another reason to celebrate.
I don't know why.
Who's really taking that seriously? Lakshya has the same one and it's very, very annoying.
No, but my definition is that other days you don't think about her. Like a Mother's Day cannot be a mother.
No, but it's not that. You just need a reason. Today is the day I want to express it to you. Okay?
I'm saying that is sad.
Why is it sad?
Why do you have to express to me on one particular day?
No, you're expressing every day.
But
you're only kind of highlighting it on this particular day.
That means you're not highlighting it enough on the other days.
No, absolutely not.
I'm just saying.
Highlighting it has to be a prominent... There is a prominency that comes with highlighting.
Why does somebody else have to define that day for me?
So you want 360... So for instance, it would be 365. So every day I will give you a rose. So 365 days give you a rose. No, right? It can't be. There's life happening around.
Why does rose have to signify your love for you?
No, but it's not... okay, so can I think that's the right point that I should take over from here and talk about my quirks.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because my biggest quirk is sometimes I deliberately cry.
Oh, that's a new one.
Yeah. You know why I cry?
It's very exhilarating after, right?
You know why I cry?
No.
So, I can't understand what's going on with... So, I'm just really upset and I end up sharing with him. Really upset. Now, while I'm sharing with him, he is practicality personified.
Nice.
Okay. So, he'll be like, move to the solution and get going.
Yeah.
I want to first experience the problem. Like, experience it right to my gut. Right down to my gut.
Yeah.
Right?
I think it's a story in every house.
Yeah. And I want to... But I feel like crying. Maybe, but I feel like crying, yeah? And then he... Because he's not responding the way I want him to respond,
like Arya would say... We're not used to making fake sounds.
Exactly. And then sometimes I actually end up getting up and saying, okay, you know what? I think I need to do this on my own. And
yeah, I can imagine that.
Yeah?
Because I can't handle it. You know, I can't handle crying.
Most men can't.
But I really can't handle her crying.
But that's okay, na? Mars, Venus has to be that way. Na? The wiring, the box is different. The wiring is different.
So, Mars has learned to go away very far away.
But I think this is what Shruti and I, Arya, at some point, need to kind of understand.
Yeah, yeah. I think give that space. This Mars right now is very hungry. My stomach is making noises.
Yeah, I'm hungry. And I also need some fresh air, actually.
Our fresh air? I think it gets sunset.